What's going on, guys? Mitch here, and today we are going for our first ride on the Fevero Essioma MX-1s. This has been a long time waiting for these things because, quite frankly, they haven't been putting them out in volume that I would like, but finally got a pair, and we're going for our very first ride. So come along and let's go have some fun. Alright guys, so we're out on the ride, obviously having a great time as always. So the first thing I noticed with the Feveros, I had to stop. I upped the tension a little bit on the cleat itself, and that's a personal preference. I set them up on the bike, I calibrated them, and it didn't even cross my mind to increase the tension, which is what I normally do on my Shimano SPDs. And the other thing, man, oh man, my shoes are so flimsy compared to my road shoes. So these are City, I don't even know what they are, but City something. I actually did a review on them on my channel years and years ago, like 7, 8, 9 years ago. And I ride them in for my mountain bike. And actually at one point, 2020, 21, 22, around there, I actually used them on the gravel bike on the Stigmata for a couple years. So the shoes have been around, but ever since going into SPDSL, obviously you change into road shoes and road pedals, and with that inherently it's just much a stiffer system. So anyway, that's the first thing I noticed is how flimsy these shoes are, so that might have to change over time. We'll see how that goes, but otherwise they feel solid. I found it kind of weird as soon as I paired the device and I had to go ride in them, that the power data wasn't actually showing up for quite some time. I would say, like, not crazy, but like probably 10 seconds. And I read something in the app about how it has to do like a self-calibration before you ride in it. So I assume it has something to do with that. Either way, I'll probably calibrate it once more after the ride, after everything's kind of shook loose and used, abused, and ready for lube. That's what she says. Anyway, I made that up, I'm sorry. Anyway, let's keep riding. And we'll stop. We'll take a look at the bearings, see the smoothness factor, and talk a little more about the pedals. So, and we'll take a look at them, obviously. I guess just let's take a car in the middle of the path. Sweet. All right guys, so we've stopped to take a look at the bike. If you want a more detailed look at the pedals themselves, I did an unboxing that was probably 10, 15 minutes long, or 10, 12 minutes. So there's that video to kind of go over more of the details and specifics. One thing I did miss is actually the pedals don't have an Allen key on the axle, which was kind of annoying. I had to find a 15 mil wrench, which I think, if I recall correctly, the Essioma road pedals are the same way. But anyway, so here's a look at the pedals on the bike, and let me tell you, they're looking pretty sweet. Essioma Pro MX on one side, and on the other the Fevero logo itself. In terms of other things that I've done to the bike since the last vlog update, I changed the seat post, and I didn't do a video on this, but I put a Thompson seat post on mainly because I wanted a little more length. The stock seat post was long enough. It's just for height of me, but it had a minimum insertion at the bottom that I was like 5 mils past, 10 mils past, and I just didn't want to deal with any problems there. So I went and got a seat post that was another 50 or 60 mils longer, and now I just have more in the frame. But Thompson, that's what I ran on. I think the Stigmata, I've run it on the Surly, I've got it on tons of bikes, so that's pretty sweet. But pedals seem to be good. Super smooth, the bearings and the grease still feel nice and tight, packed, no play. Let's take a look at the side here that has the sensor on it. Nice and smooth, no play. I'm gonna keep rolling. The one thing that I did find in the box that I didn't even say that I knew what it was, it's like a little cone and some kind of an adapter, both pieces of plastic, but I should have known. It's actually used for greasing the axle and the pedal. So yeah, that's what it's for. I can't see myself wanting to use that for at least a season after everything's kind of used, abused, and needs lube. So that's what I should have said earlier. That makes a lot more sense than what I had said. So anyway, gonna keep on rolling. The pedals seem nice and tight, nice and smooth, you know, clipping in and out, never a problem on SPDs. And they just, I feel like I'm at home, right? Like I raced mountain bikes and rode mountain bikes for 2 decades prior to getting into road. And SPDs are, it's like mom's spaghetti for me. But the shoes are just so soft compared to carbon-soled road shoes, which is just different. Okay, let's run this stop sign and try to tow this dump truck for 30 kilometers an hour. All right, so I will see you guys back at the house and we'll take a look and review the Strava ride. I'm just going for 20K, or should be 45 minutes or so. But we'll take a look at the power data to see what it looks like, if there's any ups, downs, spikes, etc. But it's a recovery ride, so I don't really care either way. So yeah, see you back at the house, guys. All right, guys, back from the ride, hanging out with my boy here, Benga. Say hi, Benga. So everything went well on the ride. The pedals actually feel really, really good. Plays good. Data seems to be pretty accurate. And I laid down on one section, so we'll see how the power is consistent. It was about a 2 minute block, so we'll take a look at that now. We'll overlay it here on the video so we can see. I don't know the timing or whatnot, but we can hopefully look at the power profile. Should have been about a 250 to 300 watt type average, I'm assuming, based on my effort that went through it. Maybe a little bit more, maybe it was 300 plus, but it was fairly intense. So on a recovery ride anyway, where the legs weren't worked in, but yeah, hopefully that looks good. Back to me. And otherwise, that's it for today on the vlog. So hopefully you guys have a great week, and we'll talk to you soon. Peace, guys.